subliminal, the subliminal, there is a subliminal issue around level when corruption thrives, large-scale looting happens. And what it does is to send a message there to the ground that essentially even the more considerate, the most moral and ethical in our own communities can essentially reach a point where if large-scale looting of state institutions is not punished, it is going to be extremely difficult for petty crime not to happen on the ground, and people just sit back and do nothing about it. In the last week, we have seen bold initiatives, and I must commend our communities and civil society groups and people who took risks to protect these businesses, to protect these malls. A lot of them are saying to us now, they did this in the absence of the state security institutions, and they are worried also about follow up about the threat of their lives. So I therefore want to conclude by saying that I think there's been significant exposure of the inadequacies, the incoherence. I don't want to call it lack of capacity of state security, because I think we've got everything it takes, but there is something else in our state security institutions that has gone terribly wrong that require national attention, not just government attention. It does require national attention, because what it suggests is that the state and the people are extremely vulnerable. Our democracy can be taken on by threats, both internal threats that those opposed to to democracy, both those opposed to the democratic path, including those opposed to us really rolling back the impact of of state capture and corruption, but also forces such as terrorist groups that we know our continent has got a lot of those social forces like ISIS, not far from here, Mozambique, the Cabo Delgado, that's instability. Looking at South Africa's state security apparatus, we have been extremely exposed. So anybody sitting there thinks South Africa has got no state security capacity to can defend itself and defend the people. And essentially, it is the job of those of us in government to fix that. And part of what we're going to be doing in our province is just that I must say that a lot of state security is a national function. All we do is to do oversight on state security institutions. But part of it just requires, when we talk of renewal, we also need renewal of this institutions. But we need a new social compact. We need a new social package. We also need a new economic deal. And I know when you use the word deal, and this is different from those who generally think that the who characterized economic transformation in a particular way. We need the deal that include every section of our population, particularly the most vulnerable in our communities. And we in Gauteng province have decided that in the coming week, and so we are going to be re-looking into a whole range of our programs, but we need also communities. We need various sectors of civil society, community organizations to be working with us to rebuild and address a lot of these problems. And I must say, if it wasn't for those organizations on the ground, we could be talking about something else. And I also want to appreciate the role of defense, the defense of our democracy campaign in this situation. So the state has been tested, but the resilience of the people are going to require that we in the state really, it's not just about the ANC fixing its house, putting its house in order, but the state has to fix its house itself. And part of doing that is that the state can't be separated from the people and civil society. We've got to work on many, many programs together than we have ever done before.
Thanks, Premier. Thank you so much for that. We will be, and for those of you who have been following the Premier's input, please put your questions in the chat group and the chat facility. We will package all of that and come back to the Premier to respond. And I appreciate, I think, the honesty and the frankness of many of your questions here. But also, please use this opportunity to raise your thoughts and ideas about what needs to be done. The Premier has hinted at some aspects of the provincial government's response, and hopefully some details will emerge from that. Norman, we're not taking hands at this point in time. Please raise your hands. I mean, put down your hands. And also, please close your videos to all of you who have them on. I think just to understand from people affected by this, people who have responded to this crisis, we've asked a couple of people to just share their insights, their experiences, and their thoughts in very short contributions of about 4 minutes each. In Alexandra Tikeledi in Kele Galadzana started an initiative immediately when this crisis unfolded, and will share with us just some of her thoughts. She'll be followed by Lucky Lakhwati, our former soccer player, who, you know, has suffered immense loss during this crisis. And then Reverend Molo will follow after Lucky from the South African Council of Churches, because he has to leave earlier, just to give us his input. So Dikeledi, Lucky, and Reverend Molo, over to you.
Thank you very much, Chairperson. I'd like to acknowledge the Premier for giving us this opportunity to come, and very few leaders who are able to come to them, and how do we move forward. As I said, my name is Dikeledi Galetsana. I'm a community leader from Alexandra. We started a movement which says hashtag reclaiming Ikasiletu, meaning hashtag reclaiming your community. Because during these lootings, we have identified that indeed these looters have taken over our community, the very same community that we and our children need to be proud of in coming generations. So there's a quote that I'd like to quote that says, history leaves no blank page. And that is why we stood up and said, let us go out in masses and go clean our community. And furthermore, moving forward, because we have seen that people looted due to situations as unemployment, situations that also created causes of crime and drugs within our community. So as young people, we are just saying that we wanted to stand up and say, let us clean and let us empower each other. Because one thing that we noticed again is that people who went there to loot do not have the education to say, what then happens after I've looted? Because yes, I will eat the food, what then after? How do I then live my life after the food has been gone? So ours is to say, we want to go to the community and say to them, this is how you do this. If you want to impact unemployment, get yourself educated, do something for yourself, open a business if you're able to open a business. But then again, we're urging the government to say, please come to us when we engage such issues so that we can engage them and have solutions as to how we deal with them. Second of all, our cleaning started last week Saturday, which is, it's still ongoing, because we believe that it shouldn't just only impact the Pan-African Mall, but it should go during within the location itself, so that these very looters can see that as a community we're standing together. There's another quote that I'd like to present which says that when you run alone, you run fast, but when we run together, we run very far. And that's one thing I'd like to preach to this forum in itself, to say, when we're engaging situations outside of the looting itself, so that we can have a better Gauteng for ourselves, so that also future generations can inherit something which is tangible. Because if we do not stand up and say we want to fight against such situations, we want to fight against unemployment, we want to fight against crime, we want to fight against so many other issues, we will never have a future that our children and their children's children will inherit. Thank you.
Thanks, Dikeleri. Wonderful. I know one's lucky, Lekwate, to come on just to share what has happened to him and his thoughts about going forward. Lucky, over to you.
Thanks. I'm sorry. It's my phone. I'm sorry. Good morning to Honorable Premier Mr. David Makhura and to all participants. I had a restaurant in Soweto, Clip Town. It's been like 3 months, you know, having it opening it. And I got a call that they are looting in deep down from the center manager. And I didn't go because of he said they are not looting at our center. But after some few hours, he called me again. He said they are looting at our center. And I left my place. When I arrived there, there was nothing inside the shop. And it was sad because of some of them, it's our friends. It's our friend people that they know me. But it's past Sunday. I went back to the shop on Mandela Day to donate some food parcels and blankets to the pensioners. And you know, it was just to show them that you know I forgave them. I forgave them. And the message that I gave to the pensioners is that as parents. From now on, whenever your child, you know, brings home something that is, you know, is stolen, please make sure that you report them to the police, because if it's not good, you know, as a parent to have something that is stolen in the house. And going forward, as the Premier has said, salute to the communities that they protected their malls, you know, their shopping centers. I'm saying as communities, you must just make sure that, you know, we learn from other communities that we must protect our own, you know, properties or our own belongings. I thank you.
Thanks, Lucky. And strength and solidarity to you as you begin to reconstitute your life and your business. Reverend Molo, from the Council of Churches, your message, please.
Thank you very much, Sean, and good morning to everybody who is part of this very important conversation. I will reflect briefly on the public calls that the South African Council of Churches have made so that we put on the table what we believe are things that needs to a response from those of us who are beginning to do the hard work of reconstructing and indeed working hard to rebuild not only the physical impact of what has happened, but also the psyche and the soul of this nation. For the Southern Council of Churches, the events that unfolded in the last little while are as predictable as they are avoidable. We have been engaging publicly and in serious engagements from the year 2015, noting and indeed indicating that with the levels of poverty that are prevalent in the country, with the cult of impunity that surrounds those who are involved in mass looting and corruption, and indeed with the hollowing out of our state institutions for some factional fights, South Africans can be lit and we as a society might end up in a very dangerous place where we are overrun. by what criminal elements and indeed factional fights that might emerge. And we made those warnings both in public but also in serious conversations with those who are responsible to run our country. And when the events of last week happened, there was a sense of anger, sense of deep disappointment. And then as you see the hurt and the pain that people like Lucky Khwati and others have to endure in their quest to build up their own businesses, at the same time needing to make sure that economic life in the townships is such that people are able to live economically viable lives in the townships. We, as the South African Council of Churches leaders, met, and in that meeting that happened last week, certain calls were end up being made, and those calls have been made directly to government, and some of them have been made to the governing party. We want to acknowledge very firmly that we are inspired by the choices that our people have made, that even within KZN, even within Gauteng, there are places where people refuse to participate in this kind of...
Again, we've seen Gauteng Premier David Makhura there highlighting the need for a new social contract, to quell the violence that has been ongoing and to roll back the impact of state capture and the need, of course, to work together on many programs to rebuild the province and the country. We've seen different organizations attending the Gauteng Civil Society Dialogue with Premier David Makhura.